Hello, I am Manali Reshamwala, an assistant professor from LJ Institute of Physiotherapy. Today I am going to talk about lever system, which is a part of syllabus in first year exercise therapy, Bachelor of Physiotherapy of Gujarat University students. Lever, what is lever? It is a rigid bar which is capable of movement about a fixed point called fulcrum. When two forces are applied in a way that produces opposing force, lever system comes into existence. Work happens when effort is being applied opposing to the load. Components of lever. Here we can assume a figure in which the components are, this is a lever system. We can say that B is a point of fulcrum, C is a weight or load, D is effort, E is effort arm, which is a perpendicular distance from fulcrum to the effort, and F is weight arm, is a perpendicular distance from fulcrum to the weight. If we see the lever in human body, we can say that lever is represented by a bone in a human body, where joint is a fulcrum, effort is a force of muscular contraction, and it is applied at the point of insertion on the bone, while weight is either the center of gravity of the part being moved or the object to be lifted by that part. Classes of lever. There are three classes of lever, or orders of the lever we can say, and it is classified according to the relative position of fulcrum, effort and weight. And they are classified into first order, second order and third order lever. Let's see them in detail. So first order lever is defined as fulcrum is between the effort and weight. We can see here the fulcrum is in the center of weight and load, so that the effort arm is equal to load arm or weight arm. There can be the change of position of fulcrum, either that can be towards the effort arm or that can be towards the load arm, and which will give the length change in effort arm or weight arm. Here we can see an example. It's a plucker where fulcrum is between effort and load. Second order lever is the in which the weight is between effort and fulcrum. So the effort arm is always going to be longer than the weight arm. Here we can see load is between the fulcrum and effort. And to understand it easily, there is an example of nut cutter where load is in between the fulcrum and effort. Next is third order lever, where the effort is between the weight and fulcrum, so the weight arm is always going to be longer than the effort arm. Here we can see the effort arm is between, effort is between the fulcrum and load. And the example can be a fork, where effort is between the fulcrum and load. One more terminology we need to understand is mechanical advantage. In lever, what is mechanical advantage? It is a measure of mechanical efficiency of the lever. And this mechanical efficiency depends on effort or load and effort arm or load arm. If we do a production of load and load arm or effort and effort arm, we will get a moment of force, which is known as torque. And if we apply that in this formula, we can get the mechanical advantage. It suggests that if the effort arm and weight arm are of equal, as fulcrum is in a center, which is shown in the first figure, in uppermost figure they have shown that distance from fulcrum to effort and fulcrum to load both are the similar. That means the effort arm and load arm are equal. So whatever the load is, to lift that much amount of effort is required to lift that load. That means there is no any kind of mechanical advantage. Pure work is done is equal to that of the load. But in a second figure, if we see, the effort arm is more than the load arm. So in that we can see the mechanical advantage is whatever the load is, less amount of effort is required to lift that load, so that in which we can get mechanical advantage. If the weight arm is less or shorter than the effort arm, we get the mechanical advantage. And let's see it in each order, like first order lever. If fulcrum is in center, we will not get any kind of advantage, no mechanical advantage. But if fulcrum is more towards the load, that means effort arm is more, then we will get mechanical advantage. And if it is reverse, we will get mechanical disadvantage. In second class order, there is always effort arm longer than the weight arm, as weight is in between the fulcrum and effort. So it is a best example of mechanical advantage. So whatever the examples comes under second order lever, all gives us mechanical advantage. And third order lever, which is of mechanical disadvantage, as weight arm is always going to be longer than the effort arm. Let's see examples of lever in human body and what does they give mechanical advantage or disadvantage. So the examples of levers in human body, for first order lever, there is example is nodding of the head. This is a nodding movement of the head where we can see fulcrum at the atlanto-occipital joint. Effort is applied by posterior extensors of the neck muscles and load is on the anterior side of the face of head. Second order lever is raising the body on toes, where the fulcrum is at metatarsophalangeal joint. Effort is by contraction of calf muscle. And load is being a weight given through ankle joint on the talus bone, where the load is between the fulcrum and effort. And the third order lever example is flexion of the elbow joint, where fulcrum is at the elbow joint, effort is by elbow flexor muscles, and load is either a center of gravity of the forearm or whatever the weight is being lifted on the hand. If we see the first order lever, it provides or it has a feature of stability or giving a kind of equilibrium status. Second order lever is more for power. And third order lever, which is of course of mechanical disadvantage, and we will find varieties of number of examples of third order lever only in our human body, which represents speed or a great range of motion. So third order lever is mostly found in human body. Another thing we need to understand is the use of lever in physiotherapy. It is necessary for understanding method of progression in strengthening muscle. As we know, if we want to strengthen any muscle or if we want to increase the strength of any muscle, either we need to apply weight and which must be increased gradually until no further progression is possible. Or another thing is by increasing leverage, that is increasing the length of weight arm. The point of resistance or point of weight we apply, if that can be increased, we can also increase the strength of muscle. As we know that effort, point of effort cannot be changed because insertion of the muscle is fixed. So we have to change the length of weight arm. By that way we can use lever in physiotherapy. The reference for these lever is being taken from Dina Gardiner, Principles of Exercise Therapy book. Thank you.